afternoon. This is the Knitting News for the 16th week of 2024. I'm Annie, and last night at knitting, Helen was making some more embellishments for her blanket, her spring garden blanket. She had a little box with her. I don't know why I'm flicking this about. She had a little box with her that was clear, and so I could see what was in this box. And she's been making some, well, really inventive, actually, more complicated flowers, bigger flowers, to really zap it up a bit. And in this box she had berries and all sorts of bits and bobs. She's also put more edge colours on and used some cotton silk blend for a different texture around the edge. I think it's a little bit more fluffy, maybe. So that's what Helen was doing. Fee wasn't at knitting, she's still in France, but she has been knitting, obviously. And she's been working on a cardigan for her friend's granddaughter. And it's all pastel colours that all blend. And it's Stylecraft Charm, which is discontinued yarn, but you can still buy some at the moment. It's 10% wool, 5% mohair, and 85% acrylic, as Andy would say. Andy sent us a photograph of her commute, which is kind of a little bit like mine, because she's working from home and I have a beach that I walk my dogs on, and she's got sort of a harbour front that she's walking her dog on. She's the best kind of commute you can get, I would have thought. Very lucky, I know. Jill has been working on, she's started another lace top. She was wearing one of her recent lace top makes and she slightly felted it, and she thinks that perhaps she shouldn't spin it in the washing machine, which perhaps she's right about. Now, she's given me this pattern for this lace top. She's knit it a few times and I quite like knitting lace from time to time. But I still, well, she gave me the pattern and she gave me the yarn as well, because it wasn't a colourway that would sort of suit her colouring. And I still haven't made it, and she's made I don't know how many. Because she's probably felted some of them as well, unfortunately. So when I wasn't around, when I went away for the weekend, I missed the Durham Guild of Spinners, Weavers and Dyers. And on that occasion, they had Familiarise Yourself with Your Spinning Wheel, which really would have been something that I would have liked to do. But I think I can take my spinning wheel on up there on any month and get help with it if I so wish. But it looked good. But I had fun doing what I was doing too. Right. I was working on, well, it's a new cast on by, it's a pattern, oh, by James N. Watts, and I'll have to look up what the pattern's called, because I forgot to do that. But it's a kind of a module in it, and it starts with a square in the middle. And I'm assuming that this, well, this all will be stitched up. And I'm not quite sure which way up it is, and it is working to gauge. But so this is Noro Silk Garden, but it's the thicker one. And he used Noro Silk Garden sock, I think. So this is going to have, I think this might be the neck bit that has some shaping. So we'll have to see how that goes. I haven't got enough of this. I haven't got enough of this colourway, I don't think. But I do have another colourway that I was thinking of making something else with. But what I'll do is not make the other thing, and because it looked like it might be a bit of a nuisance to make. And I'll do alternate segments going round. I'll use the colours alternately. So that's that one. I did do some work this week on the Murder Knits shawl, but it is a little bit, well, Joe thinks it's boring, and it is and it's not. It depends what you're doing. If you wanted to be doing it while you're doing something else, then it's ideal. Otherwise, it's a bit, well, so it's just two rows. And I have chosen to do it with 4-ply, so it's going to take quite a long time. It's not like doing it with a chunky yarn. So I've also done a little bit of work on my ugly cat shawl. I must have stopped mid-row again. They are quite long, and I'm assuming my yarn is on its way, but obviously she had to dye it and rinse it and dry it. So that's not here yet. So as soon as that comes, I can carry on. And I'm quite sure that I have... Oh, have a quick look. One that goes all the way. I've done two. So I've only got one short black wedge, and I'm here on the other side. A short one, a whole panel, and a long one that goes all the way up to the top. And then some I-cord bind off, which I'm sure will be fun. I've heard a lot of complaining about the I-cord bind on, cast on, and I did it and didn't really think too much of it. So it was all right. It wasn't a penance. Right. Oh, I've got some tea. It's called In the Mood. I'm in the mood for knitting. Can't think of anything that rhymes with that. So it is hibiscus and orange. And in this foreign language, it says hibiscus and orange. So it's the same. Right, well, I'm sure you're all busting to know about Millie, the cat, the 18-year-old cat. Millie went to the vets today and she had her blood pressure taken again, and she's been taking half a tablet. She's been taking half a tablet every day, and then one day when I wasn't here, I left instructions with my husband to give her half a tablet and half a tablet of a steroid tablet as well. So I left two half tablets very close to each other on the worktop, and then said, they're for the cat, and this over here is for Lottie, the dog. So when I got home, I said, oh, did you give her a tablet all right? Did you manage? Yeah, she was fine. I said, what, both of them? He said, what do you mean, both of them? So he gave her one of them. What completely puzzles me is how he knew which one, or how he decided which one might be the cat's, and why he only gave one, and what he thought the other one was that was right next to it, and why he didn't contact me and ask me. So she was getting her tablet at near dinner time, so I could observe her for 2 hours and make sure she was all right. But she was all right. And now she's getting her tablet at about 8 o'clock at night instead. but she's fine. So she went to the vets today, and the vet said her blood pressure has gone down to 150 instead of it being over 200 like it was. So she's absolutely fine and she has to keep taking the tablets. The vet also said, I said, do you think she can see? So the vet went like this in front of the cat's eye and the cat didn't do anything. She says, no, I don't think she can see because she's had this funny eye. So when we got home, I said to Tim, I asked her if the vet could see and she's out of that eye, and she said probably not. And she went like this. So when I was doing it at home, she started blinking. Well, that one. Can you do this? I always do it to the kids when they don't want to laugh about something. today I have a frog. I also asked the vet, could you please weigh her? Because I think she's put some weight back on because she's been eating a lot. And you know the miserable vet? Well, she said, well, this is wrong on the blood and she's lost a lot of weight. You know, she's probably got a tumour and, you know, her days will be limited. Which could be the case. But I did keep trying to explain. No, she laid in a bed for about 3 or 4 days and didn't eat anything. That's nice, that tea. So, the vet weighed her for me and she has put back on 120 grams. 120 grams would be these two and a bit more. Or nearly five of them. That's quite a lot, isn't it? Or even this apple. Because I weighed it and that's 119. So she's really filled out a bit and you can't feel her ribs anymore when you stroke her. I was wondering if the cat's put on 120 grams, if I have the same weight in cats as I have in yarn, how many cats that would be? I don't know how many cats that would be, because I don't know how much yarn I have. But I would have a house full of cats. And I wonder the volume of a cat and the weight of it. Whether that many cats would take up less space than my yarn or more. Don't think really I've got time to be thinking about things like that. I am wearing... what am I wearing? It is Family of Whelks by Martin Story out of one of the Rowan books. That does not sound quite right. It's Periwinkle Family by Martin Story. I've made it with Rico Design Pixel double knit, which is... this is quite a loud acidy colour when it's on its own, with flecks of other bright acid colours in it, like orange and green. And this is Rowan tape, bamboo tape, which was a nightmare of a yarn. And anything I successfully made with it, I made on a far, far smaller needle than it said, because it just misbehaved completely. So it's kind of a crop. Very nice, isn't it? It's funny, this tape. The tape goes like cardboard when you wash it. It goes very, very rough. Not rough, stiff. It's like that on the line. It was in Rowan Book 61 and Knitting Magazine, which isn't Rowan, 170, August 2017. Should have been made with Rowan Soft Yak double knit, but obviously any double knit will do. So, more news, maybe, next week.